In this video, I'm comparing receivers on 7 MHz. Here you can see an FT1000, an IC706 MK2G. Both are connected to sound cards and to computers evaluating the signal from the sound cards. The IC706 uses this Akai USB sound card, and the FT1000 is connected to the motherboard sound card of the computer. There are three more receivers being tested now. Here is the Softrock Ensemble. It's the modified version that I have described in previous videos, and it uses the Teratec DMX6 Fire USB sound card. And here is an Afedri, the net Afedri SDR net that you can see upside down. And here is a Colibri DDC HF receiver from Sun SDR, I think. Here is the arrangement that I have hooked up on the test bench. Starting from the output side, there are two hybrids with three outputs on each, where the five receivers and a spectrum analyzer is connected. These two hybrids get equal powers from another hybrid with two outputs and two inputs. This one does not have an internal resistor. This hybrid uses the signal from this generator and sends it in equal amounts here and here. And the other input to the hybrid takes the output from this attenuator and splits into equal amounts here and here. This attenuator sits after a notch filter on 7.198 MHz. This is a deep notch filter, and it removes everything within a passband of maybe 1.5 kHz or so. And this channel is to send some very strong signal into the receivers, but not on the notch frequency, but on other frequencies, and to see what is the interference on the notch frequency. And here is a stepped attenuator to set the level of the strong signal. The strong signal goes from an amplifier, a set of amplifiers. Together they give 74 decibels of gain. And in front of that is a hybrid. And into this hybrid, one input is an antenna. And the antenna goes through a 3 dB attenuator to present a reasonable impedance at this point. And then the other input to this hybrid goes from a stepped attenuator, and in front of that is a hybrid into which two signal generators are connected. These two can produce two equal signals and give me the opportunity to make IM3 tests. It doesn't matter if there is some intermodulation in this signal path, because no intermodulation can pass through the notch. I can also set them to measure second order intermodulation. I can put them on 3.5 MHz or anything other that might cause problems for the receivers when the level is high enough. And the receivers, the first one, the IC706, has 9 decibels of attenuation in front of it. The FT1000 goes directly. The Afedri has a 3 dB attenuator. And the spectrum analyzer has the signal directly from the port. The Softrock has 4 dB attenuation, and the Colibri 1.5 dB. And these attenuators are set to make the sensitivity the same for all the receivers at this point. So all the receivers have the same noise figure at this point, of course, except for the spectrum analyzer. I'm using that just to have an independent look at the entire spectrum and also to measure power levels. I have set this generator to minus 30 dB. This is minus 30 dBm. This is the one that does not go through the notch filter. And then I see on the spectrum analyzer that the level is minus 38 dBm. And I have now set Lindrad to run the Softrock, and I have selected this signal and set the calibration for the S meter to show minus 38 dBm. Means it shows the same as I see on the spectrum analyzer. And I switch off the signal generator. And now we have the noise floor. And the noise floor is at minus 121.5 dBm. I have reduced the signal level to minus 100 dBm. That's 70 decibels lower. And this noise level, I can see, contains some noise now. I am sending the output of this instance of Lindrad to another instance of Lindrad, which will receive the bandwidth from here to here. And that's what you see here. This is the signal coming in, and I have selected all of it here. And I can find what is the bandwidth by using the BFO. So I put the BFE on one edge, 0.8546. And here, 1.980. The noise floor is then minus 121.5 dBm in 1130 Hz bandwidth. Converting that to decibels, it gives me 30.5 dB. It means that the noise floor is minus 152 dBm per hertz. And since the power of room temperature, Boltzmann's constant, is minus 174 dBm per hertz, I can compute the noise figure. That's the difference between these. And I find 22 dB. And that's a typical noise figure for HF receivers. I have used attenuators on some of the radios to get the same sensitivity at the hybrid outputs for all the receivers. So subtracting the attenuator values, I get the noise figure of the receivers themselves. Now, measurements I'm going to do is with these attenuators in place, so it is really measuring the dynamic range assuming that the operator has used attenuators or possibly amplifiers to set the noise floor to the optimum level in each case. The loudspeaker output from the Softrock, which is the entire passband here, with the beat oscillator sitting some distance away from it, it is sent into this instance of Linrad, and here you can see the passband and the signal. I have set Linrad in the S over N evaluation mode, which means Linrad computes the power of the entire spectrum from here to here, everything, and then compares that to the power of the carrier that passes through this narrow filter. It means signal is this selection and noise is the floor here. And as you can see, the signal is about 20 dB above the noise in a bandwidth that is not very much bigger than the bandwidth of the spectrum bandwidth of the signal. This means I'm actually measuring signal-to-noise ratio. And I can make this filter a little bit narrower, makes it more critical to center the signal right, but it doesn't affect the reading until I fail to get the signal right in the filter. So, you could see a couple of tenths of a dB difference here. It's the noise that adds to the signal when having a wider bandwidth. So anyway, you can see it reads zero because I have set the calibration factor here to read zero for a 22 dB noise figure, because that was what I established this Softrock to have. Now I switch off that and instead enable this one. It's the Afedri. So I click here and now we have the Afedri instead. And I open the bandwidth just this little bit again to make it less critical. And I'm getting a little bit confused because I thought I had set this to show zero. I changed the gain setting a little bit. Like that. And seems I had forgotten I changed it. And there seems to be some stability issue here. Odd. Well, I had a USB problem. I now placed a ferrite core for the USB as well as the Ethernet cable, and then I placed some wires from the SMA connector to the ground of the USB and also to the screws holding the metal on both ends of the box. And there is a big difference. Now I read plus 3, so I go back again to 26, where it was originally, and that's not bad enough. I go down one more, but this is not a good enough situation. I have to change the attenuator. So I go back here where I were before and increase the attenuation from 3 to 5 dB. Now the Afedri is again at 26 dB in the gain or attenuation box, and I read close to zero on the S over N evaluation. So I go for the next receiver. That's the I kill the Afedri first, and here is the IC706, and I have to set the frequency right. And you can see here the IC706 is roughly 1 dB better than I had intended it to be. So I can correct the noise figure and say rather something like 12. And I have corrected the Afedri also. And then the last one on this screen, it's the FT1000. And it is close to zero, as you can see. A little bit below, but that's about where I had some of the others, I think. So I killed the FT1000 and enabled the Colibri here. And the Colibri is nearly 1 dB better also than the reference. So I think, well, I called it 20.5. I will change that just to 20. The settings of the Colibri, here no attenuation. If I cut in 20 dB, we lose the signal more or less completely. And then there is the options menu here. Use the low pass filter. If I disable that, you can see there's much more noise. I guess this is noise from other Nyquist regions. So we need the no pass filter. The front end band pass filter, if I remove that, you can see sensitivity goes up by about 5 dB, but probably it's not a good idea for dynamic range. And the front end attenuator, that also makes the signal more or less disappear. And front end preamp. It is not quite as harmful, but we need the preamp. So, this is the Colibri. I switch that off. And you have seen already the net Afedri has the gain set to 26 with the Linrad gain box. The IC706, I switch it on. It is running without the preamp. So I click on the preamp or attenuator button, and you can see here sensitivity goes up by about 5 dB. And that's not what we want. So I switch that off, and there is no other control. And here is the FT1000. It is on IP0. If I switch it over to normal like that, you can hear it's much better, and you can see here that the signal goes up by almost 9 decibels. So those possibilities to increase sensitivities should be compared to the noise figures here. But measurements I'm doing is at a system noise figure of 22 dB within plus minus 1 dB or so. It's now 4 o'clock in the morning. I will turn this stepped attenuator until I get problems in the different receivers. And the signal is going to come from the antenna, because this is switched off. I have set this attenuator very high. So, look at the screen. I don't know if it can be seen on the video, but I will go closer when I see some problem. Well, at this point you can see problems on the Afedri. So I click on the Afedri to bring that audio, and I have to switch off the audio from the FT1000. And you can see here that there is some loss of signal-to-noise ratio, and there is some oddities on the audio level. I should change the way the AGC is working before continuing. I have set zero release time and zero hold time and a long attack time. That means that pulses are going to be limited and will not turn down the volume after each pulse. And then you can see the tracing looks more reasonable. There is a 1 dB S over N loss, so I can increase the signal level to about here. Here we have lost 3 dB signal to noise ratio, and you can see in the waterfall we have some occasional interferences, and it's more visible here perhaps. And the reading I have on the attenuator is 21 dB. I can see on the Colibri it also has some interference problems, so I listen to that. And it is problematic with the AGC here. I will have to investigate that. I have disabled the AGC and set fixed gain, and it looks like this, and I go up and down with the attenuator. So I reduce the strong signal. That was 3 dB. And now there is no degradation. So I go back. This is the setting where I saw 3 dB loss in the Afedri, and it's about what I see here. I'm gonna go. More. It's a little bit hard to compare the interference in these two radios because they are so different in the characteristics. Anyway, here I have 18 dB, so between 18 and 21 for the Colibri. I'm now on the IC706. And you can see here we have something like a 3 dB loss of sensitivity. That's with a setting of 4 dB only. So I disabled the 706. and look at the soft rock. This is the IC706, and you can see interference coming and going, and the effect on the signal to noise ratio ranges from small up to maybe 8 dB or something like that. And you can judge from here. The attenuator is now 5 dB. The Softrock, you can see down here, I switched to the audio from the Softrock. And look at the S meter reading from it. And now, when the whole thing is red, then there is a problem with the Linrad evaluation, because the level is too high. But now you see, the soft rock is okay for a while, but also the IC706. So they are fairly similar. There is a small loss in the soft rock, but sometimes nearly no loss at all. And still 5 dB on this strong signal attenuator. The FD1000, I switch off the soft rock, which is on now, and on with the FD1000. And now this is the maximum signal I can have. And if I look at signal to noise ratio here, that's the yellow track, and I switch off the strong signals, and there is no difference. At night, the FT1000 is very good, because it has front-end filtering, and strong things on medium waves does not affect it, as it does with the other radios, I think. This is the power spectrum from DC, well, from 300 kHz up to 14 MHz, 7 MHz at the center. And these levels are not very high. So I could add 6 dB more gain in the amplifier chain. And now I have a clear degradation with the FT1000. And this is more than 3 dB. Well, now it's less than 3 dB. So, I need to set that generation to zero and add 6 dB extra gain to get into problems with the FT1000 at this time of the morning. It's 4 o'clock. 10 past 4. I have now tuned the soft rock outside the notch filter, and I turn on the antenna signal, the attenuator for it, like this. Now I have an increase of the noise floor of 10 dB, and there is some interference, but if I look at some lowest noise point, you can see it's still about a 10 dB increase of the noise floor, and that is for HF maybe a little bit more than what is normally recommended. So I turn down a little bit. Well, here we have a 6 dB noise increase. That happens when the attenuator is set to
34 dB.
And that means that the Colibri and the Afedri have about 15 dB margin on this 14 MHz dipole when listening on 7 MHz at night. And the other radios have somewhat bigger margin. And this is the list of the results found with this comparison, 4 o'clock in the morning.
The time is now 20 minutes past 3 in the afternoon. I'm listening to the FT-1000 and turning up the antenna signal, like this. And you can see something happens out here. And look at the S-meter. We lost about... Well, 1 dB now, 2 dB. I don't have the extra amplifier. I cannot have that in daytime because it gets saturated. But you can see here, we have some interference. Not much, but a little. The RF spectrum looks like this. And we have a lot of signals up here. Maximum at about 12 megahertz. Well, that's partly because of the characteristics of this antenna, which is tuned for 14 megahertz. And looking at the S over N, you can see it occasionally goes down to nearly minus 3 dB. So, I can take this as the maximum signal for the FT-1000. And it is with 0 dB on the attenuator. And it's clear, you can see interference coming up occasionally. And you can see it here also. And, well, a little bit more than 2 dB signal-to-noise ratio loss. This is the IC706. It has some interference now. As you can see here on the S over N graph, that is with an attenuator setting of 6 dB. This is the Softrock. I'm now running with the attenuator at 14 dB. Camera is slow, I think. Anyway, what you see here is a false signal that enters the selected passband now and then. If I attenuate by 10 dB, look at the carrier here, 10 dB, and it almost disappears. Sorry, and back to the 14 dB setting. And the degradation is in the order of 3 dB here. So, daytime, the Softrock requires a 14 dB attenuator. This is the Afedri. You can see there are occasional things in the notch. And it's clear from the S over N graph that you have about 3 dB loss of signal-to-noise ratio. And it's very visible also in the waterfall. And this is with an attenuator setting of 24 dB. The behavior of the Colibri is a little bit different. it gets some kind of clicks. I guess it's because of saturating the AD converter. And you can see on the S over N graph, it looks a little bit ugly. So I reduce the level by 2 dB. And the interference, I mean the signal-to-noise ratio is very good most of the time, but there are occasional clicks. So maybe 1 dB more signal, like that. Means that the ranking for the Colibri comes here at 25 dB on the attenuator. And the time is now 10 minutes to 4 in the afternoon. And this is the spectrum I'm right now sending into the Colibri. The time is now 15 minutes to 6 in the evening. The RF spectrum has changed a little bit, but interference is much worse. I'm now listening to the Colibri, and I have to attenuate more. 1, 2. Well, only 2 dB made a big difference. And as you can see, also the Afedri benefited a lot from those 2 dB. And the attenuator is now 27 dB. So I switch off the Colibri and switch on the Afedri. And you can see clearly it is minus 2 dB. I add 10 dB of attenuation now, and then you can see I get about a 2 dB advantage. So I go back and maybe 1 dB more signal. And since things change a little bit with time, I wait a little bit. I can look at the sun SDR. Here you can see the waterfall. There is interference occasionally. But there is also in the Afedri. So Afedri and Colibri are fairly similar. I check now the Softrock instead, and I have to make sure that the frequency is the right one here, and I have to add more signal to get interference here, 10 dB, like that, and that is reasonably okay at this time. Now, you have interferences here and here, and about a 2 dB loss. And the reason for the interference is this AM station, which is an intermodulation product, and this one as well. So this is approximately what the Softrock can take. And the attenuation for that is 16 dB. The IC706 does not like this at all. I remove the Softrock and switch on the IC706. And you can see it has about 6 dB of degradation. And it varies a little bit with time. So I add let's say 2 dB more attenuation here. And that's not enough, a little bit extra. About that. And I have to wait a little bit because stations fade up and down, so to be reasonably honest, I have to wait a little bit. But I see now 20 dB of attenuation. That's the limit for the IC706 at this time. And finally then the FT1000. And I turn on maximum signal. That's too much. And this is also too much. And it seems I have to change the tuning a little bit. And here we have a degradation in the FT1000 of, well, more than 3 dB occasionally. And this is also too much. And looking at the waterfall from the FT1000, looking like this, and we still have interference occasionally. So this is probably because there are more stations that are close spaced, because the FT1000 has a different architecture. It's far more sensitive to interference from nearby stations. And this is still too much. So, about here. And the attenuation now is 12 dB. So the ranking between receivers depends on where the strong signals are relative to the frequency of interest. The time of day matters. This was 4 o'clock in the morning, and here is 20 minutes past 3 in the afternoon, and the difference from FT1000 to Colibri was 25, and here it was 27, but at 15 minutes to 6, it was only 15 dB. That's because this FT1000 is a little bit degraded by close-spaced stations. The ordering between Softrock and IC706 has changed from what was on other times. But the general thing is FT1000 is a little bit better than the Softrock, and the IC706 are not very different. They were the same here. And then Colibri and Afedri are clearly not as good as the other ones, and they are fairly similar all the time. Now I have disconnected the antenna and switched on this generator and also switched off this one. And that is to look at the filter, because this signal now goes through everything here and through the notch filter. This is set to 20 dB, and I look at the Softrock, and as you can see here, the level is minus 13.8 dBm, according to the calibration I made yesterday. And the spectrum analyzer shows minus 13.6 dBm. So this is within what I can expect of the thermal stability of everything. I stepped the frequency of this one by 10 kHz to get to the center of the notch, or close to the center of the notch. And then the signal is not present anymore. I click at the center of the notch and turn up here by 20 dB. And now I can see it. Here we are. And I step in steps of 100 Hz. Upwards. And you can see the signal is stronger now. And you can see here as well. And now I'm outside the filter. In the other direction. And now it's outside the filter. And you can see here, minus 100 is approximately the strongest signal I have anywhere in the passband. And at the passband center it was, well, I don't remember, I had to. Here. At the passband center, it was about minus 120 dBm for this signal. So the notch is very deep and does what it should. Now I step 10 kHz away. So the signal is 10 kHz below, and the Softrock is saturated. You can see here the AD converter is saturated. And I'm looking for a 3 dB degradation of a signal here. So I switch on this generator and look. Well, it's centered, and I look at the evaluation, but I have to find out from where is the sound coming now. There. Now it's quiet, and I switch on the Softrock. And look for the SN evaluation, which is as it should. And I increase the signal level, 10 dB, too much. So, the strongest signal I can have is with 11 dB of attenuation here, but I can read it here. Minus 4.5 dBm. at 10 kHz. Here is the FT1000, and you can see here the signal to noise ratio. I switch off the strong signal, and we have a 3 dB degradation. And that happens already at an attenuation setting of 41 dB, which means that the signal level I have is minus 34.5 dBm. Here is the IC706, and I look at the SN graph and switch off the strong signal and on with it again. So this is the point of 3 dB sensitivity loss due to reciprocal mixing, and that is at 34 dB or minus 27.5 dBm. And here is the Afedri, and I switch off the strong signal, put it back again, and the level is 19.5 dBm. And here is the Colibri, and it is not degraded at this level, and 1 dB more of signal, and it's saturated. So the safe level for the Colibri is minus 18.5. And that's with 25 dB on this attenuator. I'm listening now on the Colibri and step the frequency 10 kHz further downwards. And it doesn't like that. But 1 dB is enough to solve that problem. And you can see there is no degradation. So this is some kind of saturation problem. And the level now is minus 19.3. And here is the Afedri. And I switch off the strong signal, put it back again, and the level is 19.5 dBm. And here is the Afedri, 20 kHz separation, and there is a loss of signal to noise ratio, and I switch off to see it is not quite 3 dB, but one more dB signal and the loss is much larger than 3 dB. And the signal for this is minus 17.6 dBm. And here is the FT1000 switching off the signal like that. And you can see on the waterfall very clearly. And on the S-meter evaluation, it is about 3 dB. And put the signal back. The level is minus 34.2. Here is the IC706 at 20 kHz. And without the strong signal, you can see in the waterfall that the noise is lower, and also on the spectra, of course. And here, it's about 3 dB. And the signal level is minus 21.3 dBm. And here is the Softrock. I add one more dB to the signal, and you can see there is saturation, and this is saturation on the sound card. And the Softrock itself, the op-amp, saturates closely above this level. But S meter evaluation shows there is not really any degradation, so there is no reciprocal mixing problem at 20 kHz on the soft rock. And the signal level I have here is minus 4.3 dBm. The strong frequency here is now 100 kHz below the center of the notch. I'm listening to the soft rock and try to bring up the signal level. This is the point where the AD converter were saturating before, but the signal margin now is 60 dB. But that is the data coming out from the AD converter. It is sampling at a much higher frequency than the 96 kHz, so the AD will saturate, maybe fairly close, maybe not so close. Here it's saturated. And this is the point. And the audio coming out after the digital filters inside the AD converter is very low, but there is a strong signal not far above the Nyquist frequency of the AD converter. I mean the Nyquist of the downsampled data. And the signal level is minus 0.3 dBm. Here is the FT1000 at 100 kHz. The signal level is minus 7.2 dBm. And the S meter, S over N degradation. When I switch off the signal, you can see it was about 3 dB. Here is the IC706 at 100 kHz, and switching off the strong signal, you can see the normal 3 dB, and you can see that on the S over N evaluation. And I put the signal back to lose some, and the level for reciprocal mixing on the IC706 is minus 12.2. Here is the Afedri. I go up one single dB. And you can hear and you can see, and the S meter shows like this. So here is the safe level, and it is minus 17.2 dBm. And this is the Colibri. One more dB and it saturates. And the signal to noise ratio is perfect up to the point of saturation. And the level I see is minus 19.2. I'm giving decimals all the time, but these decimals don't really mean anything. The frequency separation is now 1 MHz. I'm listening to the Colibri, and I bring up the level by 1 dB, which is not acceptable, but at just below this point, the signal-to-noise ratio is fine. And the level here is minus 20.5. And here is the Afedri, 1 MHz separation. I bring up the level by a single dB. And you can hear it's not good. And of course, see it here on the S meter. If I switch off the strong signal completely, like this, the difference is not visible. And the level here is minus 17.6 dBm. Here is the IC706 at 100 kHz. and I look at the signal to noise ratio, I have to center the frequency, of course, and then switch off the strong signal. Well, it's not quite 3 dB, I make it a little bit stronger. Something like this. And then the signal level for the IC706 is minus 4.5 dBm. And here's the FT1000 at 1 MHz. And I switch off the strong signal. And it's very clearly visible. Of course, also here. And the signal level for that is, plus 5.9 dBm. But that was with some saturation on the analyzer, and now it gives plus 5.5 dBm. And here is the Softrock at 1 MHz. And I look at the S meter, signal to noise ratio, and I increase by a single dB. And this is not good at all. So it means probably that the op amps saturate here. The level is plus 1.5 dBm. Here is a summary. At close spacing, the Softrock is a clear winner, 30 dB better than the FT1000, and 15 dB better than the Afedri and Colibri, which are direct sampling receivers. And the IC706 is not much better than the FT1000, just a little. These are conventional receivers. They suffer, of course, from reciprocal mixing, having noisy local oscillators. 20 kHz away, the Softrock is still much better than the conventional receivers, and also much better than the Afedri and the Colibri. At 100 kHz, the Softrock is still the winner. But the differences are not so big anymore. At 1 MHz, the FT1000 is the best one. Note that these direct sampling receivers have the same limit, regardless of the frequency separation, more or less. And the Softrock, when we come up in a high enough separation for the op-amps to not see the signal anymore, it goes a little bit higher in before it saturates. And conventional receivers are not good at close range because of reciprocal mixing. Now both of these generators are running. The antenna is disconnected. These generators are placed 10 kHz and 20 kHz respectively, below the test signal, this one, which is used for the establishment of sensitivity. And things are combined and sent into the different receivers. And right now I'm listening to the IC706. And I turn up the signal level. And here we have intermodulation. And it looks like it does not disturb, but that's false because it becomes red. Lindrad decides this is a strong signal, so it is not counted in the noise background. So I can switch on some frequency modulation on it, like that. And then after a while, Lindrad will forget there was a signal there. And now we can see that the level of this intermodulation degrades the signal-to-noise ratio by 12 dB. So I think 3 dB less signal or so would be appropriate. Something like this. Maybe like that. No? Here. So this is the level to get the IM3 product equal to the noise floor. And that is minus 39.5 dBm. Here is the FT1000. And it's partly the intermodulation and partly also reciprocal missing, I think. I switch off the strong signal. And we have about 3 dB, but there is some difference here also. Well, here. So it's not only this. And I switch back. Well, I switch off the other strong signal as well. There are two of them now. And then we have some spur here. And it now goes up to the 3 dB. So I put them back, both of them. And look at the signal level. It's minus 38.3. This is the Afedri. 10 kHz separation and third order intermodulation. We have a 3 dB degradation. But the signal level is very low. It is minus 72 dBm. Now, this is low level IM3, and it's a direct sampling receiver. So, this is probably digital feedback in the AD converter. I bring up the signal level now by 10 dB. And as maybe unexpected, the intermodulation becomes weaker and not stronger. It is not intermodulation, it's another phenomenon. More the signal. And now it starts to grow, really. And more signal, it doesn't grow. But here it's... So, something like this. Well, a little bit too much, maybe. But here is a sweet point where the intermodulation is very weak. And I can go above it a little. And I can take this as the level for IM3, and it's a significantly higher. It's minus 50 dBm. And here is the soft rock. It's a 3 dB degradation. And the level of the two tones is minus 24 dBm. And here is the Colibri. And I bring up the level 1 dB more. And that's too much. Yet another dB. And it grows by 3 dB. So, I take this level as the highest without having intermodulation problems. And this level is minus 29 dBm. I've increased the separation to 100 kHz, and I'm looking at the Colibri, and you can see the level is a little bit too high, 1 dB less, and there is no problem. Well, is it centered properly? Yes. And the signal level. Of each tone is minus 29.7, let's say. Here is the FT-1000, and it's lost about 3 dB of sensitivity due to the third order intermodulation here. And this is at the signal level of minus 29 dBm. And here is the IC706. I had to turn down a little bit to get this 3 dB signal-to-noise ratio loss. And the signal level is now minus 38 dBm. And in the Afedri, the IM3 is high, of course, again. So I turn the signal levels downwards. And then the IM3 increases. And I turn it upwards. And I was at that sweet spot I saw before. But the interference level is too high. It's not really what we want. So I go down. Something like this. And the level is minus 50 dBm. And since this is digital feedback, it's not really the IM3, so it's a little bit difficult to know how to use this, because this kind of interference is probably disappearing when I connect an antenna signal. I will do that. There's now an antenna signal that brings the noise floor to a normal level for listening on this band. The IM3 is no longer much visible. We can see it here weakly. And I step it upwards, 10 dB. Well, maybe too much. Something like this. Well, maybe here. And the level now is minus 47. So it didn't make very much difference. And here's the Softrock. I still have the antenna connected, but you can see the intermodulation here is roughly degrading by 3 dB or maybe 2 dB, and that's for a signal level of minus 19.5 dBm. And I disconnect the antenna signal like that, and you can see it doesn't make any difference at all, because this is not a direct sampling radio. It's a conventional SDR, and the sound card is doing the sampling, and the sound card doesn't have digital feedback because it operates on a very low frequency. So here is a summary of the third order intermodulation. The IC706 is the same at 10 and at 100 kHz.
That's not the case with the FD1000, because it has several conversions inside, and there's filters that reject one of the signals when we come a little bit further in separation. So this is 10 dB better at 100 kHz. The Afedri, it is a wideband AD, and there's no difference. And the same for the Colibri. The Softrock, there is a very small difference, and that is because at 10 kHz we get problems in the sound card. But at 100 kHz the problems come maybe from the op amps, or maybe from the mixer itself, I'm not sure. And it doesn't really matter. Anyway, you can see from the numbers, the Softrock is the obvious winner. At wide separation and at narrow separation also. Now I switched off one of them and set the other to half the signal frequency, because I'm looking for second order intermodulation, that means the second harmonic as generated in the receiver. And first here is the Colibri, and you can see the interference here, and I have it still frequency modulated to not make Linrod think this is a desired signal. Sorry, to think it is a spur, a carrier that shouldn't be included in the noise. Anyway, the degradation is about 3 dB. I'll switch it off, and you can see the signal level is minus 68 dBm. So it is a very weak signal on half the frequency that generates this problem. It is, of course, not second harmonic. It's something from the AD converter. And we can see that because if I increase this signal by 10 dB, it doesn't go up as much as one would expect from a normal distortion product. And I go up 10 more dB, and then you see it drops. 10 more dB, it drops even more. And 10 more dB, and now it saturates. So this kind of signal level is not problematic, and now the signal is pretty strong, minus 23 dBm. There is now an antenna signal present. Well, a little bit too strong actually, so I have to turn it down. Something like this. And then I have some of the intermodulation, but this is a fairly strong signal, and I turn it downwards in steps of 1 dB. Sorry, in steps of 10 dB. 10 dB. 10 dB. And it doesn't come back. So, starting from here, this is minus 26 dBm. And from this strong signal level I go down in steps of 1 dB. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. And it comes back again. And you see it's a severe degradation problem here. So, with the antenna present, this is the first point
where there is a problem from second harmonic, and that's at minus 38 dBm. So a filter would be a good idea here. And here is the Afedri, also with the antenna still connected, and the same setting. So I turn the level down from here, steps of 1 dB. I need to go something like this and enable the audio output, so we can see here maybe a little more signal than this. So here is where the intermodulation starts with the antenna signal present on the Afedri. That's minus 42. And I can bring the signal upwards to see if there is a sweet spot somewhere. And there is not. Now, when I disconnect the antenna, like that, interference comes back, and I lose sensitivity because of that. And this is at a very low level, at half the frequency. It's minus 75 dBm, so it is a very weak signal that is very likely to be present at 3.5 MHz while you listen at 7. So it looks harmful, but it isn't, because you are very likely to have a lot of other signals present also. I can turn the signal up, 10 dB, 20 dB, 30 dB, and then something happens. 40 dB, not much, 50 dB, here it goes up. So this is the behavior with no antenna signal. And the lesson to be learned is that if you have a completely digital radio that goes from more or less DC up to 30 MHz, there should be a filter bank in front of it with half octave filters or a tunable preselector or something. Otherwise you are likely to see interference, both things of the frequencies of third order intermodulation and also overtones of lower frequency signals. This is the FT-1000. And here is the signal-to-noise ratio. And I switch the generator off. So you can see the loss due to the overtone is about 3 dB. And the level on 3.5 MHz is minus 20.5 dBm. So it's a strong signal. And here is the IC706. And the signal to noise ratio, and switch off the generator. So we can see it's about 3 dB. And I put it back and find that the level is minus 36.7 dBm. And here is the Softrock. And S over N, and I switch off to see it's about 3 dB, and the level for that is minus 37.7 dBm. Here is a summary of the sensitivity to half the frequency, the second harmonic, how it is generated in the radius. The direct sampling units, the Colibri and the Afedri, with an antenna, they are similar at about 40 dBm. And the IC706, as well as the Softrock, they are about the same, 37, 38, 42. So this is roughly equal. But the FT1000 is about 20 dB better. So it has some front-end selectivity, and that could be helpful.